Hi guys, welcome to my channel, I'm John. Today I'm going to share with you how to create this abstract butterfly particles animation using the new simulation node in Blender 3.6 geometry nodes. So this video will be really simple. Without further ado, let's get started. So press A to select everything in the viewport and delete them. Then I want to import a butterfly 3D model as our base shape. I've put the download link in the description below. Please download it and follow along the video. Go to Geometry Node tab. Add a new geometry node. Add a distribute point on face. Let's increase the density to 20 maybe. Then I want to turn the points to vertices so that we can extrude it later. Okay, now we need to extrude the point using simulation node. Then add an extrude node in the simulation zone. We want to extrude the vertices. Then we want the simulation node to keep extrude only the top vertices. So all we need is add a store name attribute before the simulation zone. Set this to boolean on each vertex. Let's name it top vertex. Set the value to true. Then in the spreadsheet, we can see all the vertices we have at the moment have the top vertex set to true. This is not what we want because currently it is select all the vertices we have and actually we only want to select the top vertex. So to select only the top vertex, let's duplicate this store name attribute and put it after the extrude node. Then connect the top to the value. Then now if we see the spreadsheet again, we are now only set the top vertices to true and the other vertices are set to false. Then to let the simulation node know that we only want to keep selecting the top vertex and extrude it, we need a name attribute. Set it to boolean too. Name it top vertex as well. Connect the attribute to selection in extrude node. So every time when the simulation node looping, the name attribute will get the information from the store name attribute here and tell this extrude node to keep select this top vertex and extrude it. Okay, now let's play the animation to see the result. Everything is good for now. Let's tidy up all the node here. And next, we want to make the simulation zone to extrude the vertices and grow on the surface of the butterfly. So to do it, let's duplicate the butterfly base shape. Then we need to get the normal of the butterfly. Then we need to sample the surface of the butterfly. Change this to vector. Connect them. Connect it to offset in extrude node. I think we can reduce the offset scale so that we can get more vertices. Play the animation to check the result. Okay, everything is still a random mess. Let's add a cross product. Add a noise texture and connect it to cross product. Duplicate the cross product. Set it to subtract. Let's subtract 0.5. Play the animation again to check the result. Okay, now we can see the butterfly shape. let's play with this noise texture to get the texture we want. You can try to put any value you want to experiment it. Play the animation again. Okay, now we get the shape we want. But I think we can add a scale to make it nicer. Okay, now let me explain a little bit about how all this node works. So this is the geometry of our butterfly 3D model, and here we have a normal node. That means we get the info of the surface of the butterfly. Then we have sample nearest surface. This node can tell us about the closest point and the shape of the butterfly. Then we have cross product. The cross product here actually take the shape of our butterfly 3D model and mix it with the noise texture. Then it come up with the noise texture that grow on the surface of the butterfly. Okay, now let's group all this node. Name it grow noise texture on butterfly surface. Next, when the animation is going on, I want to slowly trim down the line and make it disappear at the end. So to do it, let's turn the mesh to curve. Then we need a resample curve to limit the vertices. Let's put 50 maybe. Then add the trim curve. Then add a scene thumb node. Connect it to start. Add the map node and set it to divide. Try divide 100 maybe. Check the animation. I think this is too fast. Let's increase it to 600 maybe, and also increase the end value to 650 maybe. Check the animation again. Okay, this is good for me. I think we can also add keyframe at the end value as well to make it trim nicer in the beginning of the animation. Drag the thumb indicator to 0. Put 0 for the end value. Hover and press I to add a keyframe. Drag the thumb indicator to around 100. Put 1 for the end value. Add a keyframe. Then we can add a set smile tab. Set it to nurbs to make the line smoother. Okay, now let's frame all this node and name it trim effect. Then next, instead of turn the curve to mesh, I want to turn the curve into points so that it looks like particles. Let's increase the count to 22 maybe. Okay, now we have done everything for the simulation. The last step for this particle is I want to increase the base point to make it look nicer. Play the animation again to see the result. Okay, this is good for me. Next, we can start to add material. Select the butterfly, go to Material tab. Rename these particles. In the node editor, add a set material. Select particles. Go to shader editor. press home button to see the node. Delete the principal node. Go to render properties tab, change the render engine to cycles. Change the device to GPU, turn on render preview mode. So here we can see, we want the center part to be brighter and the outer part to be darker. So let's add an emission node. Add a color ramp. Add a texture coordinate. And connect the object to color ramp. Add a vector math node. Set it to length. Then add a math node, set it to divide. Adjust the value until we get the result you want. Play with the color ramp as well. I think we need to move the butterfly to the center. Press Ctrl A and apply the location. Okay, now add the color we want. You can add any color you like. Increase the emission to 6 maybe. Then I think we can reduce the point radius smaller. Let's go back to the geometry node. Add a set point radius. Put 0.003 maybe. Let's turn the background to black color. Then I want to add a floor as well. Add black color for the floor. Then press numpad 1 to see the front view. Add a camera. Press Ctrl alternate 0 to frame the view. Move the camera to center. Okay, now we done it. So if you like my video, please subscribe and see you in the next video. Bye.